Hey.
What's up, baby?
Ooh.
Oh.
Today is Sunday. It is about 8 o'clock, but gotta get up and get the day started. I'm gonna take you through a week in the life of a grad student.
Kiss is a must, otherwise I won't make it through the day, and I have to set the whole thing up at night. I put the coffee in, put the water in, and just
come in and push the button while I'm getting ready.
And that saves me a lot of time.
I have to listen to gospel when I get ready or something that will calm my spirits and get me in the right mindset for the week or the day. You gotta take it day by day. I left the house at 7:52 this morning. My class starts at 8 o'clock. And this is why I live right up the street. I do not recommend living far away from school if you can help it.
7:55, guess who's at school? And my class is right there. Got a park and everything. That's why you gotta get here like before 8 o'clock. It's a couple spots. Encourages you to be on time, even though it's not always me. But it encourages you to be on time. I've literally had on some form of Prairie View associated clothing all week. I'm pretty sure last week too. If it's not like a Black Fox shirt, then it's like just like a Prairie View shirt. I represent, or I'm lazy, and these are the only t-shirts I have. Either way, it is 7 a.m. I'm picking up Ty and Rachel. We're about to go do some community service, so yeah. I am going to a pizza night with my friends from the program, and I will be bringing my board because in my backpack, because if I don't, I'm gonna feel guilty, even though I've been studying pretty much all day. So phone's on the way. So Ty gave Rachel, I'll try to put it down. Yeah, Rachel a glass of wine and gave me the whole bottle.
That's the problem.
Oh, where is she? My cousin said save the bottle too.
Are you gonna? What are we gonna study by?
Ain't you gonna call Tyra?
When y'all gonna study biochem? Oh. Whatever that means.
Call them.
Y'all are a joke.
Grandma child.
It's not even. Okay.
We're getting burgers, and it looks delicious.
Like, it's not the same.
We're having a little girl's day.
Like, it's
a little girl's time. What you finna cut open?
My burger. I'm gonna cut my burger.
Y'all are childish. I'm a woman. I eat my burger as a whole.
Because
I'm an adult. So, my mouth is.
You got experience. She got experience. She had a lot of practice.
Okay. With eating burgers, yes. All right, well, I just got back home and it was fun while it lasted, but I have to clean up a little bit and then get back to studying for the rest of the night, and I have to do the same thing tomorrow. So, yeah. So yesterday, we got an email and I don't think they meant to send it to Black students, but it's really strange. It says, Critical Conversations, is America no longer a white Christian nation? And I guess it's a book signing for Robert P. Jones. And his book is The End of White Christian America. And my first instinct is to be upset and like, just like kind of, what is this? So I'm going to the book signing. I need to know what they're talking about.
What y'all talking about?
All right, so I just got out of the book signing not too long ago. I'm actually really glad that I went and I was able to speak. And another girl, like, he was answering different questions, but it seemed like mostly in the book he was talking about, or like just things he was mentioning, period. It seems like it was more about religion and politics. So he like brought up politics a few times, but then he started bringing up stuff that I wasn't expecting him to bring up. Black Lives Matter and the counter arguments with Blue Lives Matter. And he's saying most of the backlash, surprisingly, is in white Christians, when those are the ones who are supposed to be accepting. So the fact that white Christianity or the white Christian America is coming to an end, in a sense, he's basically saying, of course, that there's more minorities here now and a lot of people are leaving the white Christian churches. And I brought up a reason like, okay, well, it could be because you said they're so strict about certain things down south and, you know, they want it to be segregated and people aren't really, not as many people are having that anymore. Like, they're like, I grew up with friends or people of color, or, you know, they just don't want to be a part, or either they don't want to support them being gay or whatever the case may be. I think a lot of us came in ready to be offended, but you just have to, a book title is just a book title. And what he did was grab attention with it. And that's marketing. That's like what the purpose is, because had the book been named something else, probably wouldn't have came. Like, I have better stuff to do. But because that was the case, like, I needed to know what this man was talking about. Like, what are y'all doing on our campus? Like, what is this?
I just got back home. It's like right after the election, so it just hit. That was brutal. It hurts. It definitely hurts. And as you all know, I'm in the middle of Mississippi. At a PWI. And I don't know, I've just never had this feeling before. Every person that I've talked to is kind of gonna be like a struggle to go to school tomorrow, to still have to wake up in the morning. And then you don't know how it's gonna be, or you kind of fear for your safety. It's scary to go from Obama to this, to having so much hope to this. I was just talking to my friends and I'm like, oh no, nothing's gonna happen. I mean, it sucks. Yeah, like, we're sad, but like, the fact that we even have to consider that, you know? Well, yeah, it's almost 4 a.m. and I have to be up in like 3 hours for class. So if I can make it. I am currently in my bed studying and I have this study pulled up for one of my quizzes. It is 10 o'clock. So yeah, I've been doing this stuff since I got out of class around, what time did I get done today? 12? It goes A's for ambition, B what I want to be, C past the situation that's in front of me, doubt is an enemy, Z we say fuck them, the irony is they inspire me to love them, G is past go and ignite the cash flow, when H is put your heart in whatever's your last hope, I is I inspire, but you light the fire, so we be the streets. I am finally getting in the bed,
just got back from studying. I haven't slept for like more than 3 hours in like the past like 3 days. If that makes any sense. I'm so delirious. But like, I didn't get more than 3 hours last night. I didn't get more than 3 hours the night before. I've been getting in super late. So it's after one, almost two, and this is like the earliest I've been in. So I'm gonna try to rest because I have to get up early again. I need to eat something, so I'll probably put something on my stomach and try to get some rest and wake up early and kind of do it all over again. I'm exhausted. I'm so tired. People ask, like, how do you forget to eat? Like, don't you get hungry? Like, I literally have not left my bedroom all day. It's almost 5 o'clock and I'm just getting something from the kitchen. So I've been trying to take care of business and make phone calls and study. That's how you forget to eat. You're busy and you're not thinking about hunger. Like, oh, I'll eat after this, or let me finish this chapter. But yeah, then I was about to die, so I had to eat. Good morning. Well, it's the next morning. I stayed up pretty late studying until I fell asleep, and then I woke up this morning studying. I have two quizzes and a test today, so I'm on my way. I did some self-study for my test later, and then now I'm about to go meet with a study group to study for our quiz. That's in about an hour. Okay, so I just got home, got out the shower, did my two quizzes today and my test, so hopefully they all went well. I know, well, my quizzes went well. I hope my test went well. I have not had a break all day. Like, I got to the school before class, was studying. After class, had to study for the next thing. Got like 5 minutes to eat and then had to like be out the door again. Now I have to read, let me see. It's 8 o'clock. We got out of class early, of course, because our test, if you finish, we usually get out at 9 p.m. My night is nowhere near over. So I just got to accompany these lovely ladies to church this morning. Say, hey, y'all.
Hey.
It was real good, even though we didn't get to hear the word today. It's Appreciation Sunday, so I'll be back next Sunday. And every Sunday, because it was popping. Was so nice. Good morning. I am reporting live from my hotel room in Tennessee. So I'm coming to do a tour today at like one of my dream schools, Meharry. I'm so excited to be here. I've never been to Tennessee before, so I'm about to call an Uber from my hotel room and go ahead and head down to the school. See what it's about, try to make some good connections. I heard that it's like really good if you try to get a tour before, and that way you can kind of, I don't know, make some connections and really figure out like what the school is about and where you're gonna be if you do get accepted. So that's the goal, that's the plan. All right, so yeah, we came to Princess Hot Chicken. It was recommended by a few different people. I'm gonna show you. I got some spicy chicken breast. No, I'm not supposed to. Oh, it came with it. So right now I'm struggling to get ready. We are going to take a girls' trip to New Orleans to see Bait. So, yeah, we're going to the Beyonce concert, but last night, it was a tough week at school, so a couple of us got together and hung out, and this is the result. I'm struggling, and man, the world needs better laws. Maybe then we'll be better off. I'm hoping that it comes, but it never does. I just wanna be the man my dad never was.
Hear my music, it's all soul. Just got new grills and they all gold. So I got that beef with the popo. They don't like my style, no, no, no. I don't really give a damn, I keep steering. Switch gears and the fans just keep cheering. No interceptions, no interference. I'm on an A-team, no Ed Sheeran. I'm headed for the stage, now they clearing all the bad women in the building.
Last night, Ayesha recorded all my snaps as we were in a music video. Like, if you go back and look, all the videos is like this the whole time. She's crazy. We drink it down so we can
look down. Why? It's good, Dad.
What model is it? Oh, what model?
When you're growing a nigga like me, there's no limit, baby. Make you say,
Are you recording? Now I am.
Oh,
we're on the road, on the way to Texas. These my neos. Hey, turn up, turn up, turn up. It's time for homecoming, okay?
What?
She said follow her.
Follow me on Instagram at DBabyDrake.
Hey, Tunde.
It's recording.
Yeah, it's recording.
What's up? How y'all doing this evening?
It's the morning, afternoon. All right, so I finally made it to school. I'm walking through this neighborhood because the parking was ridiculous. First of all, they were charging. But I just got in. It's like I've been moving all day. And I'm about to head to the band field after I move my car so I can get closer because I have to learn this new dance tonight before the game tomorrow, where we're performing, so fun stuff.
Life's too short, fucking up is necessary. Cause one day all these bad women up and marry.
Smoke clouds in the shell, fade, fade, fade. Smoke clouds in the white, get fade, fade. Smoke clouds in the shell, fade, fade. Stick your tongue out, let some light get fade. Smoke clouds in the shell, fade, fade, fade. Rain tongue out, let some light get fade.
Told my homie life is such a bitch, I feel it. He said, why don't you hit it like a chick and kill it and treat it like your main. Maybe take a fucking train to the highest mountain up in Spain, make it rain. You know what my life is about.
So it's the day before Thanksgiving and I decided to stay at school. My roommates and I are having like a little get together, so I've been out shopping and trying to prepare for this all day. I'm gonna start cooking tonight. We're trying to get it popping over here. So far, I'm making the turkey, the greens, and I'm gonna make some rice and gravy and some macaroni and cheese from scratch. So that's what I usually eat for Thanksgiving. That's what I put on my plate, so that's what I'm cooking. Lord, I have had the longest day. I'm so tired, my back is hurting. But just coming to update, I got all my candles going. I bought this new candle, it's lavender and chamomile. That's embarrassing. It's chamomile. But oh, it's making my room smell like a spa. And then I have two gingerbread house candles going. Kind of get it smelling like the holidays. Got my greens cut up, kind of making the roux. My macaroni and cheese is started. I haven't put any of the cheese in it yet because I'm gonna save that for tomorrow so it can be fresh and melted for everybody. But I just wanted to go ahead and get that done, especially since I have to use the same pots. Still thawing the turkey, and I'm on this video chat with my parents. I'm away from home and my mom wanted to cook with me, so we're cooking together, kind of. My back hurt, my neck hurt. Yeah, I'm vlogging. I don't know if they can see you. You wanna say hey?
Hey.
Okay. So, don't mind my head. I had to put it like this so I can get in the shower. The gathering was supposed to start 11 minutes ago, and of course, I'm in a robe. Of course, but the food is almost ready. Here's the turkey, still smoking in there. To show you when it's out the bag, the greens, and now I'm about to make
Oh, it's the cake. We have a store-bought cake. We're still college students. Oh, I'm about to make rice and gravy from scratch, so.
All right, so it is dark and it's during finals, but my friend needed to talk, so coming over here briefly. I got about 15 minutes to spare.
Hi, friend Mike.
We're gonna put this on a porn site.
Him coming out of the shower?
Mm-hmm. I don't know.
I don't think he has the porno body.
She's trying to come for you, dog.
I'm not, IJ. I'm saying that you seem like a good, God-fearing man that wouldn't want to be on that type of site.
That ain't what she said.
That's what that meant.
That was nothing at all what she said, though.
Why is it in my bed?
Did you hear what he said?
Yeah.
What did he say?
He said, why am I not at the library? Because Mike is selfish and said he needed something.
So I'm selfish and I needed something.
Because his test is over and I have two. How many tests do you have left?
With me? I'm done.
Oh, I bet.
Done.
He was available to talk because he's done.
You know how you watch those movies and there's like a kid with like a camera who's recording the whole thing?
Like,
that's you.
Like,
you know what movie I'm talking about.
This, I'm just thinking of the scary movie. This is heavy. I'm done. I hate you.
You're not gonna open it?
You want me to open now? I was gonna wait till Christmas.
Oh, yeah. I guess you should.
So, I'm back at home, studying for another final. And that's in the morning. Then I have my board over there that I'm like constantly looking at. And, you know, mentally studying. I guess like I'll think of something and then it'll kind of like be on the board, or like I'll quiz myself kind of while I'm doing other things. But anyway, I walked into one of my finals today and I was smiling. People were so mad. Like, why are you smiling? Like, and I had like a couple people ask me, but I didn't realize like I was smiling. I just feel like that represents grad school. Like, why are you smiling? There's nothing to be happy about. Like, we're all sad. I don't know. I just feel like I'm so sad. Like, I'm kind of just over it. And like, it's funny, but it's not funny.
It's a celebration, baby, if you wanna hold. Spit a bottle with me, we could wrestle in our clothes. Laugh until our stomachs look like 8-pack muscles. It's a celebration, baby, if you wanna hold. Spit a bottle with me, we could wrestle in our clothes. Laugh until our stomachs look like 8-pack muscles. And we'll party like we're 17.
Why you jumping on her? Hey.
What's up, baby?
Ooh.
Oh! Rose underscore Trey. Doctors in the making. Gotta get it.
How we live. You know what I'm saying? We look broke right now. We look struggling. You know what I'm saying? We trying to get A's and K's.
Rachel, this is a holy vlog.
Just remember this day.
Please.
I want to be on the side.
Come on. I'll get y'all.
All I need to say is I want to be the next.
No, I don't trust you with the camera.
I ain't going to drop it.
I don't trust you. Does he look trustworthy?
No.
Hell no.
Look at me. I'm gonna do the running man. Wait, like, you know, you come back in and out of the camera. You can't follow me.
Oh, I'm sorry.
All right, so good night, everybody. Have a nice trip.